Also following breaking news right now at 5 o'clock, crews are on the scene of a house fire, and Pinpoint News Tracker shows us exactly where this is all happening. It's on Triangle Drive and in East Haddam.
In East Haddam, let's get out to Channel 3 Eyewitness News reporter Caitlin Francis. She's there live. Caitlin, I can see a busy scene there behind you.
Yeah, it's been a very busy morning for these firefighters and crews here on scene. We are on Triangle Drive, which is where the fire happened. That house is just behind me. I'm going to take a step out of the scene so that you can see what we're seeing. We just arrived here about 15, 20 minutes ago. The fire was knocked down within the last 10 minutes, but you can still see those crews putting water on what's left of that house. This fire ripped through this home here on Triangle Drive in East Haddam. You can see it's basically burned almost to the ground there. We are going to work to get some more information about exactly what happened, if there was anybody inside, because we do not know that at this hour. But again, the call came in about 4 o'clock for the fire here, and the roads are so tight getting to this house. Crews are basically bottlenecked trying to get close. There were tons of emergency lights leading up to the scene. And just for reference, we are right at the end of a cul-de-sac next to the Mudus Reservoir here in East Haddam. East Haddam crews, Colchester, and surrounding towns all responded. And as I said, those crews were backed up all the way to Lakeview Drive, which is several streets away from where we are right now on Triangle. We are still working to learn more details. We're trying to confirm some more about exactly what happened. And again, we don't know if there was anybody in the house at the time that the fire started, but we're going to work to get those details for you. We'll bring you any updates live on air, and you can follow along with the Channel 3 app as well. Live in East Haddam this morning, Caitlin Francis, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.